Hey, how you doing, buddy? Politics? No, let's not talk politics. We have red and white. That's all we have at this place. Jay Reynolds, been here for a long time. Welcome to PJ Clark's. I've been a bartender at this place for 28 years. My babies were little. My daughter and son were 3 and 4. I started here in 1986, and the reason I remember that is the Bears won the Super Bowl. 1986, we opened up in March. They won the Super Bowl in January of the 1985 season, and the rest is history. Yeah, it's last call. My son's in New York, my daughter's in LA. They're both professionally working now. I got that out of the way. We've had great celebrities pass through here. The umpires for the Major League Baseball, the players don't come in here so much because they don't like to mix with the umpires. We had Kevin Costner here. This was before the cell phones, and people and girls were running across the street and getting throwaway cameras and shooting shots, and he was very gracious, never got out of hand. We had Walter Matthau here when he shot another movie. I think it was Dennis the Menace. He shot Dennis the Menace here, and he was in here for lunch quite a few times. I served him, and I also had Jason Miller from The Exorcist, the priest, one of my favorite guys. I ended up going out with him for a couple drinks. Milo O'Shea from The Verdict. He played the judge in The Verdict. He was also the priest in Romeo and Juliet in 1969. And I came in, he was doing Mass Appeal at Water Tower, and I was walking by the bar, and I also like to patronize in this place as well, and I saw Milo O'Shea at the end of the bar, and I went, oh my God, Milo O'Shea. I came in and talked to him like he was a good friend of mine. The guy was just a great guy. I loved The Verdict, Romeo and Juliet. I was in the Air Force at the time, brought a lot back, a lot of memories. Is that Grace Kelly? Who is that on that cover? Well, this woman used to come in here back when we first opened, a lovely lady. Her name is Barbara Ann Scott. Her and her husband were big real estate developers here in Chicago. And in 1986, she was coming in here on a regular basis, absolutely beautiful at that time. This cover is 1952. She was a silver medalist in the Olympics in 1952. And when she, in 1986, I believe she was like 60 years old, 65. And absolutely stunning and beautiful, as you can imagine. One thing I didn't tell you, back in 1986, cell phones were like a brick. The big thing when we opened up PJ Clark's, we had a telephone at every table. So they got to plug in their real phones, a telephone. So that was a big thing. And now, of course, everybody in the bar has their machines. The sad thing is, a lot of people aren't socializing. They're absolutely, this is the saddest thing about working nowadays compared to back 20 years ago. People came in to mix the lively art of conversation. That's what it was all about, and it should still be. But everybody's so into their machines. They could be a good-looking guy next to a nice girl. They could have a nice meeting, but they don't even look at each other. Nobody bothers each other with their phones because they feel they're invading their privacy. When they're on their phone, they're like with their friends on their phone, so people don't talk to other people because they're with their friends. I really love it here. So, hey, next time you come back, come in a little earlier. We can talk a little bit more. And but we got to run. Thanks a lot.